So now you don't only have to scan devices on your local network, you can also scan external IP addresses or host names. So I'm going to scan my server here by typing Nmap and then the I or well the host name of my server. It's gonna take a moment. And I've got like a lot of open ports just because I have so many different things running. I've got there's a lot of things that run on it and some things that I just set up that I've never really used and I haven't bothered to shut them down. And so what we get here is my host, and we can see that I've got FTP, SSH, SMTP. We've got the standard domain and HTTP, POP3. There's a bunch of stuff here, and I'm not going to go into what all those are, but we can see that these are everything that the server has. Now you can also set a file. So let me clear this. Let's open up gedit. So we're going to create a file of hosts that we want to regularly scan, and this can save time when we scan them. If you've got like a few hosts that you regularly check on, so I'm going to put pointy bracket dot net 192.168.0.1 and 192.168.0.100, and then I'm going to save this as networks.txt. So what we can do there is we can type nmap dash il, so it's a lowercase I and a capital L, and then the location of that file. So it was networks.txt in my home directory. And it's going to scan each of the hosts that is in that networks file. And it returns in the order that they were scanned in. So that's pretty neat. I want to go over a few more things with you guys regarding this command. It does get pretty big. There's so much stuff that you can do with this. And so I really urge you guys to go and explore this if networking is one of your interests, if you want to really follow that. One of the things that I want to show you guys is how we can turn on OS inversion detection during the scan. And so what we're going to do is type nmap dash capital A 168.0 to 100. And this is going to scan. Oh, there. I had a little typo in the IP address there. So I had to just fix that. So this should tell me the operating system and versions that are running on the devices on my network. And you can also find this information about other hosts. Aside from this, just while this is running, you can scan a network and find out which servers and devices are up and running by using the flag dash lowercase s capital P. You can display the reason that a port is in a particular state by adding the flag dash dash reason. You can choose to only show open ports, which appears to be the default functionality here. It doesn't show the closed ports. You can actually also show all of the host interfaces for a machine by typing dash dash iflist in the list of arguments for this command. And I mean, again, it's really big. So go ahead and look this up. Just if you want to type in google.com nmap commands, there's a bunch of different ones that you guys should probably play around with. This was more of an introduction on to the most common or basic functionalities of this program. And actually, I'm going to cancel this here. And I'm just going to restart this so it'll go a bit faster. I'm just going to target my own IP address here so that we can get this done. And you guys can see the example output that this is going to do when adding the dash A flag in here. So here you can see a lot of information about this machine. So let's go up to the top here. We've got the port, the state, and the service, as well as the version of the service. So I have Apache 2.4.12 installed, and that's also the same one here. And if we go down, we get more information about the host itself. So we have OS is Unix. We've got the computer name, the domain name, if any is configured, the fully qualified domain name, and just a lot more information. So that is the Nmap command, and it would be useful if you're trying to just scan your network. One of the examples that comes off the top of my head that would be, you know, when I would use this command is if I notice that the internet's running a bit slow. Let's say I've got 10 people in my house and half of them may or may not be using the internet, and I want to see how many people are online. This is what I would do in that instance. Or if you want to check how many machines offer a certain service or what the IP address is that you need to use to access a certain service on another machine, this would help you figure that out. So thank you guys for watching this video. I will see you guys again soon.